you down to the vice presidential debate right here at Longwood University in Virginia. It is less than 2 hours away. And as we cover this election here at CNN, we are traveling the country, talking to voters in battleground states in partnership with Instagram, Facebook, and CA Technologies. And as part of this, we want to hear from you. So please post photos on Instagram. Tell us who you're voting for. Make sure you use the hashtag MyVote. Your picture could be used in our election coverage. Well, now let's hear from a man who's been in a high-pressure debate exactly like the one we saw tonight. The Vice President of the United States, Joe Biden, talking exclusively with our colleague Chris Cuomo earlier today. Here he is.
Polls are tight. There's a suggestion that it's even getting tighter. The main points of dispute are the need for change, the questions about trust, and the idea of energy. That's what Trump is saying. Those are his advantages. How do you answer those questions here in Florida?
I bet he couldn't carry his bag 18 holes on one of his own golf courses, speaking of energy. But look, I think the real issue here is can you imagine any president of the United States saying any of the things that he has said about, can you imagine a president getting up at 3:30 in the morning and tweeting vitriol? I really mean this. This man lacks any sensibilities about the American people. I just don't get it. And he is so woefully uninformed on foreign policy, it's dangerous.
But they've worked for him, Mr. Vice President. Well, people take it as strength, as speaking the way we do. He doesn't play those games that politicians play, and they reward him, or at least don't punish him for saying things that you find out of bounds.
Well, I think that they're now starting to focus, Chris. I mean, this is getting deadly earnest now. Every election, the last four presidential elections, people make up their mind later and later in the process. Granted, there's not been a lot of enthusiasm across the board here, but now they're beginning to focus, and they're getting to see who this guy really is. And I predict to you she will win, and she'll win clearly.
When you hear about situations where Trump says he's smart for finding ways to use the tax law as is provided, it bothers you. You say that it suggests something that's wrong about his disposition. But other people say, well, that's what the tax code is about, is finding ways to pay the least amount possible.
No, I thought it was about making sure you did your part for your country. I grew up in a household where my father used to say when someone talked, and it never made any real money. And they'd say, I'm paying this or that in tax. My dad would say, it's a small price to pay. Since when does somebody who lives at the top of the world in the penthouse overlooking the world be in a position where he doesn't feel any obligation at all to pay any federal income tax, to support the military, to support education, to support our foreign policy? Since when is that a patriotic thing to do? Can you imagine any other president that's existed to ever say that and be proud of that? I can't fathom it.
Trump is making headlines for saying that those who avoid PTS, post-traumatic stress, are strong. Those who succumb to it, therefore, by implication, are weak. He wasn't being insulting. It seemed in the video of it, but it does speak to an ignorance about the issue. What does that statement mean to you?
This is an ignorant man. This guy says things he has no idea about. He's not a bad man, but his ignorance is so profound, so profound. Can you imagine what that means if he believes that and he acts on that? What that means for, I carry a card with me every single day, and I hope I have it with me now. It's my schedule here. And on my schedule, I have a little box on the schedule. I have my staff contact the Defense Department every morning at 6 o'clock to tell me exactly how many troops are injured, exactly how many troops are wounded, because everyone matters. It's not 6,700 and some. It's 6,753 deaths, not 50. 53. It's 52,419 wounded. And the number of people coming home with unseen injuries, post-traumatic stress and traumatic brain injury, is significantly higher. That's why we need another 50,000 nurses right now to take care of these people. What's this say about a guy who doesn't have any notion of that? Come with me into the battlefield like I've done over 20-some times in Afghanistan and Iraq. Look at what these kids are going through. Look at the sacrifices they're making, and look what they go to sleep dreading. I was asked to present a Silver Star to a young man who had jumped into a young commander, jumped into a burning Humvee to pull out his buddy after an IED exploded. This kid, and the kid died. The commanding general, General Ordinario, asked me to pin on a Silver Star when I was there. You know what the kid said to me? I don't want it. I don't want it. He did not live, sir. He did not live, sir. That kid probably goes to sleep every night with a nightmare. And this guy doesn't understand any of that? How can he not understand that? How can he be so out of touch? He's not a bad guy, but how can he be so out of touch and asked to lead this country?
The debate for the vice president.
Yeah.
What do you want people to remember?
I want them to remember that whomever the vice president they're looking at supporting is someone who has the trust and confidence of the president, their candidate, and believes what their candidate believes, because it is not, and no longer is it sufficient for a president being able to handle everything himself or herself. They need additional help. And one of the great, great gifts I've had being vice president is the president has given me major responsibility, turned it over and said, just do it. Presidents from now and in the future are going to have to do that. And so if you have a candidate, like I have a feeling, I don't know, that Mike Pence is, that I don't know that he really thinks a lot of what Trump is saying makes any sense. What a hell of a way to make a living, to be vice president, have to get up every morning and support someone you don't agree with. Maybe he does. And if he does agree with him, then people can see the difference in policy here. I know Tim Kaine. He's smart as hell. He has significant experience, and I know Hillary. She called me before she, not, I didn't, but she called me and asked my opinion. I know she trusts him, and I know he'll be able to fill that role.
Great interview there with Joe Biden, and no matter where you stand on this, no matter who you're thinking about voting for, can't say you weren't moved by that story with the young man and the Silver Star that he just told Chris there. As we get closer to the main event tonight, this crucial debate, we're going to talk about Hillary Clinton's post-debate bounce and our new poll with the new numbers just out. Could the ground shift again before Election Day, as it did in the past 30 days, 34 more to go? Stay with us for more of this special edition of Outfront.
From breakfast burritos to late-night quesadillas, 20 decadent cravings, dollar all day at Taco Bell. Let the feast begin.